just like a Rocky movie. This is insane.
Voted the best bout of 2018. Watched by millions. An instant classic. Aung Lan Sung and Ken Hasegawa captivated thousands at the Thawana Indoor Stadium in Yangon, Myanmar, and the martial arts world with an epic five-round battle for the one middleweight world championship in June of last year. The two Goliaths of the division are set to repeat their struggle on March 31st as one makes its historic debut in Tokyo, Japan. This time, the tables are turned. Aung Lan will be defending his belt outside of his home country for the first time, while the challenger, Hasegawa, will be the one with the home advantage. Aung Lan Unsung, a sporting icon, a beacon of hope to his people. Myanmar's first ever world champion.
I've been given this tremendous platform and I want to use it for the right reasons. This platform allows me to reach more people, but I think in our lives, you should use whatever platform you have to show positivity, to create a better environment to live in.
Born in the rural, mountainous region of northern Myanmar, Aung Lan's rise from a remote farming community to become one of the best martial artists in the world is just a glimpse of what is possible for a country just emerging from seclusion.
There's a misconception that Myanmar is like a dangerous place. It's a beautiful country to visit. A lot of the people in the country are not very rich. They're very giving. One day I want to just be able to give back to them.
His martial arts journey began during his college days in America, where Aung Lan fell in love with Brazilian jiu-jitsu and the grappling arts. While his skills were developed in America, the focus and dedication that defines his work ethic was forged much closer to home.
I have a lot of respect for my father. He raised five of us, gave us the best education. It's hard coming from Myanmar, coming from a small village to get a high level of education, but he made it happen. His hard work ethic and his sacrifice made it happen. There were lots of times when he didn't spend much time with us when we were a kid, but that's part of the work that he had to do. A lot of sacrifice went into him, and I'm very thankful for his work ethic.
Sacrifice, suffering, and work ethic are words that Ken Hasegawa knows well. The 32-year-old is blessed just to be competing.
そうですね。MRI 取ってもらって、お医者さんに見せたら、でも歩けんのっていうぐらいの首のヘリになったんですよ。まあ歩けたんですけど、手も動かなくなって。
Hasegawa built a stellar reputation in the proving grounds of Japan. He became a deep openweight world champion and remained at the very top for 2 years. A neck injury while competing in 2017 brought all he'd worked for to a sudden end.
めちゃめちゃ痛かったですね。上は向けない、2時間以上寝れない。痛み止め飲んでも2、3時間でなんか切れちゃうんですよ、なんか効果が。首から下が動かなくなるかもしれないって言われた時はすごく怖かったんですけど、でも格闘技ができないって僕の中でかなりなんか嫌なことで。
Crying Chronic pain and isolation took its toll as he fell into depression. He refused to go out or answer messages. Racked with doubt and shut off from the world, Hasegawa reached rock bottom. But there were those who refused to give up on him. There were those who saw greatness in him, despite his circumstances. Hasegawa returned to competition the following year and won via first round submission.
Two
warriors, both competing for a purpose greater than themselves, each unwilling to take a backward step. Aung La Unsung takes on Ken Hasegawa once more with the one middleweight world title on the line on March 31st in Tokyo, Japan.